Star Wars is a franchise beloved by millions of people all around the world. Spanning across three different trilogies, almost everybody has loved a Star Wars film. However, Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker, was slammed by critics, and Disney had to manipulate the Rotten Tomatoes audience score. It made the least money of the newest trilogy, and even writer-director J.J. Abrams isn't proud of how it turned out.
For those who hate it, I could not respect your opinion more. And for those who love it, I question your sanity.
It was just all over the place, but it was, you know, to those who didn't like it, I totally get it, respect it. To those who loved it, I'm grateful and dubious of your taste.
But despite all of this, I am here to tell you why The Rise of Skywalker is actually the best Star Wars movie. Right off the bat, we see Kylo Ren on a quest. It's great because no other Star Wars movie jumps right into the thick of things like this one does. We're wondering, what is he doing? It's brilliant. Then he finds the Wayfinder thingy which drives the whole plot. We then learn that Palpatine is back. He's been pulling the strings the entire time. Genius. And what could be more despicable than raising a million Death Star ships up from the ocean? It's pure evil and makes total sense. So good. This movie is also the first fetch quest movie in the series. The entire plot is our characters going from place to place, finding thingy to move the plot forward. It's a new take on Star Wars that's seriously brilliant. Kylo Ren also has a redemption arc. The way he throws his lightsaber is so metaphorical, it's even better than Vader's redemption because there were no metaphors when Vader turned good. Genius. From the very beginning, we see this film's genius writing. No opening crawl has been this shockingly written. It's psychological and brilliant, just like this line.
Somehow Palpatine returned.
Just look at Oscar Isaac's face. The writing really lets him shine as an actor. It's brilliant that the second Death Star was made relevant again, bringing everything full circle. The knife from this movie, the Death Star from the originals, it all makes perfect sense, and the way they connected these trilogies together is brilliant. But the writing in this scene takes the cake.
I'm the spy.
What? You?
We don't have much time.
I knew it!
Once again, the actors say it all. The force healing is also brilliant. It shows how powerful Rey is as a Palpatine. She basically invented this ability. And it's genius that Kylo could use this power too because they are a force dyad, which is also genius writing. There isn't time to talk about the reveal of Rey's lineage, but when you really think about it, it's genius. Rise of Skywalker is a brilliant conclusion to the saga. It brings perfect closure to all our favorite characters. Luke gets to make fun of his own joke, and finally achieves his goal of lifting an X-Wing with the Force. Leia sacrifices herself to save her son, and Han Solo gets a cameo as a memory. Amazing. Anakin Skywalker gets to bring balance to the Force twice.
Bring back the balance, Rey, as I did.
And the last scene of the saga is seriously perfect.
There's been no one for so long. Who are you?
I'm Rey.
Rey who?
Rey Skywalker.
These are the perfect last words of the saga, because Rey represents every single Jedi who has ever lived, and Skywalker represents the main characters of the first six movies. It all comes full circle. And that, folks, is why Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker is the best Star Wars movie ever made. Thanks for watching.